Blurring the background of an image is a great technique to put the focus on a subject, making it stand out from a busy background. Let's take a look at how easily it can be done using Photopea. You can follow along by downloading the image in the description. First, let's create a new project by dragging and dropping our image into Photopea. Next, duplicate the layer our image is on 2 times. I'll rename the bottom layer Original and hide it. Rename layer 1 to Background and layer 1 Copy to Subject. The first thing we need to do is create a selection of the subject, which you can do in several ways. With the subject layer selected, go to the Select menu and choose Subject. This automatically makes a selection of what Photopea thinks the subject of the photo is. It takes a few seconds to process, and our selection is made. If you're working with an image where Select Subject doesn't work properly, you'll have to draw the selection manually with the Pen tool or the Lasso tool, or you can add and subtract from the selection that was made to refine it. In this case, the selection's perfect for what we want to do. Next, we want to mask out the background and isolate our subject, so they're not affected by the blur. To do that, click on Layer, go down to Raster Mask, and choose Reveal Selection. Now, if I hide the background layer, you can see our subject has been isolated. At this point, we could apply a blur to the background layer and it would look okay, but there's a problem. Make sure the background layer is selected and unhide it. Go to Filter and choose Gaussian Blur. I'll set the radius to a high amount, 20 pixels, so you can see the issue. Notice there's a silhouette surrounding the subject, almost like a glow. This is because the subject is being blurred along with the background. We need to remove the subject from the background layer, so when the blur is applied, this silhouette won't appear. I'll close out the blur without applying it, and hide the subject layer. Control-click the mask we created on the subject layer, which will make a selection of the mask. We need to expand this selection by a few pixels, so go to Select, Modify, and choose Expand. From here, we want to expand the selection by around 5 pixels. This way, some of the background will be selected when we remove the subject, which will help the process create a smoother result. Next, we need to remove the subject, which we can do by going to Edit, Fill. From here, make sure Fill is set to Content Aware, and click OK. It will take a few seconds to process. And this is our result. It doesn't look perfect alone, but it removes our subject completely, which will prevent the glow issue when we apply the blur. Unhide the subject layer, and with the background layer selected, go to Filter, Blur, Gaussian Blur. Now there's no silhouette around the subject, even if I turn the radius up to 400 pixels. Let's set it to something a little more natural, like 10 pixels, and click OK. This looks nice, but there's one final detail that will make it look even more natural. If I hold down Alt and scroll up on the mouse wheel to zoom in, you can see that right now the edges of our subject are too crisp, and it makes the image look fake. What we can do is double-click the mask on the subject layer to bring up its properties, and slowly increase the feather to make the edges of the subject blend into the background a little better. Don't go too far with the feather, because you don't want to make parts of the subject transparent. You just want to smooth out the edges a little, and remove some of the sharpness. I'll go with 2.6 pixels. You can see how much more natural it looks now that the edges are smoothed out. That's all there is to blurring the background of your images. I'll select the subject and background layers, and click the folder icon to add them to a group, so we can switch between our original image and our new image with the blurred background. You can see how much she stands out now as compared to the original image. There's much more focus on the subject in our new image. Practice with this technique and see what you can do with your images by putting the focus on your subject and blurring the background. experiment with different types of blurs or other filters to see what you can come up with. Thanks for watching. See you next time.